God is our loving Father forever. He, through His Son Jesus Christ, has attested Dill Ministries International, DMI, as one of the most loving, exceedingly powerful, mega church ministries that wipes the tears of multitudes with immediate signs, wonders, miracles, and healings. The blind see, deaf hear, dumb speak, lame walk, various dreadful diseases instantly disappear, and all the tears of the brokenhearted are wiped away at once.
Pastor, this is Uma. This is her first time to the service today. She said for 2 years she's been having pain on her right leg, just as you called it. Instantly said the pain is completely gone, completely healed.
Completely gone, mother. Completely gone. Just now you can look at this, dear mother. Look at this, dear mother. Just now it went. And this is the first time, mother, you have come. You come from India. Lift your hand to Jesus. A blessed mother. First time, 2 years, this leg pain is gone. Who healed his loving mother? Jesus. Who healed his loving mother? Jesus. Lift your hand to Jesus. Your right hand became whole as the other. He is here today. Rise, stand forth in the midst. Stretch forth your hand.
Pastor, this is Clementina. She says for 3 months, she's been having a severe pain in the right hand, had difficulty lifting it. Today, through the Holy Spirit, you said
move
right
it,
hand.
Child.
It's
it
healed
up.
Completely.
Come up. All the pain has gone. You couldn't do it for some time, child. 3 months you couldn't do it. And you can do it now. For 3 months she couldn't do that. How many of you believe Jesus is here? Lift your hand to the Son of God. Move your legs. Move your legs. Move that right leg. Bend down and see.
Pastor, for 5 months, Emmanuel has had pain on the right side of his leg, exactly as the Holy Spirit spoke, and he was not able to lift up this leg comfortably. But tonight he's able to do that without any pain.
Do it, sir. 5 months you couldn't do it, sir. God bless you. Lift your hands to Jesus and say thank you to Jesus.
Pastor, this is Solomon. He has two healing testimonies. The first one, he says that his wrist was swollen 5 months. He could not lift anything heavy. He did not even have the strength to lift. But he says that tonight he came, the swelling was there, but right now it's going down, healed completely.
It's all fine, sir. Completely fine. Show it to the camera. Lift your hand to Jesus and say thank you to Jesus. He loves you, son. You'll be a testimony always for his glory. Loves you. Yes, sir.
And he has been having a dizziness, a kind of a dizziness that he does not also understand. The doctors also don't understand.
Yeah,
but tonight, completely healed. No more dizziness.
Lift your hands. Marvelous. Marvelous, Jesus.
Pastor, this is Stephen.
Yes.
Stephen had excruciating pain coming from his hip to his left thigh. And he came with that today. And he is fully healed.
You feel fine as the dear son. Your pain is gone. You can move your legs and show. All the pain is gone, son. You can stamp your feet. You came with that here. And it's gone, son. Who healed this, dear son? Lift your hand to Jesus. Jesus just told me, dryness, dryness, dryness in the throat. Dryness in the throat. Irritation in the throat. Sore throats or whatever you can call it. Dryness and sore throats and irritation in your throats. It's coming out now. In the name of Jesus of Nazareth, risen. All these defeated ailments in the throat. Leave, come out now.
Pastor, this is Estella.
Yes.
She says that since she was a girl, young, she has been having dryness of the throat. But tonight, through the word of knowledge, when you said someone is being healed, instantly she felt like saliva was being created in her mouth, much more than she could not even imagine.
To God be the glory. Loves you, child. You are healed. Live, my daughter.
Pastor, this is Mabel and her doctor, daughter Victoria. Both of them have testimonies. Mm-hmm. For 3 days, she's been having throat pain and fever. Today, she says the fever is gone. The pain is completely gone. And Pastor, she was suffering with a severe headache. Instantly, the pain is gone.
All headache healed. For you has gone. And your child is also well. Double healing to the mother and the daughter. Lift your hand to Jesus.
Let's see.
Jesus is placing his hand on you and saying, be thou whole, be thou healed by the power of the Holy Spirit, by the power of the Holy Spirit. How great
thou art, how
Matthew's Gospel, chapter 8. I will read the first 4 verses. When he was come down from the mountain, great multitudes followed him. And behold, there came a leper and worshipped him, saying, Lord, if thou wilt, thou can make me clean. There are other translations that says, thou can make me whole. And Jesus put forth his hand and touched him, saying, I will, be thou clean. And immediately his leprosy was cleansed. How many of you love that word, immediately? It doesn't take time for God. It takes all the years for a little man like me or beloved ones like you. And ultimately we do nothing. But for him, it doesn't take time at all. How many of you believe tonight your miracle is now in Jesus' name? He loves you. The Bible says if you see every healing, every miracle, every work, word of God, every work of God didn't take time. It was then and there. Let there be light. Oh, light came. Let the waters come. Let the earth come out of the waters. Boom, the earth came. He is beyond our imagination. He is God. Psalm 145 verse 3, Psalm 147 verse 5. He is infinite. His greatness is infinite, my beloved. He loves you. He loves you. He loves you. He is here today. Isaiah 29 verse number 14. I will do marvelous things, wonderful things in your midst tonight. Isaiah 29 verse 14. Habakkuk 1, verse number 5. What I do, even if I tell you and explain to you, you will not understand or believe. That's what God tells me and tells you. We are little people. We are his children. We are his children. He wants to be our father forever. That's the role of God. That's the place of God in your life, prime place. That's the preeminent place of God in your life and my life, to be, to take the position of a father. When he takes the position of a father to you and me, I tell you, my loving children, life and life in abundance will flow freely into your life. We must give him that place. We are coming there tonight. The Holy Spirit leading me and leading you. His leprosy was cleansed immediately. And Jesus said unto him, see thou tell no man, but go thy way, show thyself to the priest, and offer the gift that Moses commanded for a testimony unto them. My loving children, here is a man, a leper,
outcast. He was a social outcast. He was a religious outcast. My loving children, according to the blessed religious laws of that nation, he was a religious outcast. He was a despondent. He was lonely. He was lonely. My loving children, my beloved children, I came to know, and I was reading and hearing about a man, I can't tell the name, my beloved, whose fame was so much, my beloved. He rose in his own, I can't tell you anything more, in what he was doing, in what he was excelling, in what he was being successful, in what he was, I would say, well-renowned all over the world at that time for what he was doing. And he was the talk of every home in the Western arena of the hemisphere, of the globe, or even sometimes on the East. My loving children, his fame shot up so much with all richness and wealth and whatever, whatever, whatever. My beloved ones, it was so pathetic, it was so heartbreaking to hear the final words of this man who was in such fame. He was not 90 years old. He was not even 70 years old. He was much younger than that. At the height of his fame and wealth and this and that and that, the words he uttered just few hours, thanks be to God, I believe he has gone to Jesus, what he told my loving children, it's heartbreaking, said, I am the most lonely person on this earth. And without him, I would be nothing. My loving children, said, that was a few words that man spoke with all the wealth and the worldly fame and all what he did meant nothing, my beloved. My loving children, this man, this leper, here so lonely in life, even the rich and the richest can feel so lonely, so wretched in life. It's not wealth. It's not the amassing of wealth or friends or whatever, my loving child. One man, Christ in you, through his Holy Spirit, can make you the most rejoicing personality on this earth. Oh, you can have everything, my beloved, but without him in your life or my life, it is vain and it is waste and is worthless. This is what, when I read my beloved, I was totally shocked how he went. But thank God, he was born again. My loving children, he just made it. My beloved ones, if you are here tonight for any other reason, if you are here in this blessed great ministry, one of the great ministries of this world, God bless every ministry, better and great. Thank God for them. But we are one of those such good ones with the great power of God. It's all by him. And I tell you, my loving children, if you are here tonight for any other purpose, I beg of you with my hands clasped, that you become the child of God tonight. He is ready. He wants to reveal himself and take his position in your life. He wants to take his place in your life as your father. Why not let him? What do you lose? What do you lose? Is money your father? Is money your happiness? Is wealth your happiness? Your career your happiness? Your success your happiness? My loving children, or your achievements, or your talents, or whatever is your happiness and your fulfillment? That man said, I thought my fulfillment was in this and this and this and this. And he came to that place. He realized he was climbing his own mountain rather than the mountain of God, Jesus. All the love is gone.
God, son, what a miracle. Lift your hands to Jesus.
He could not even jump, but now we can jump.
A jumper. Don't need that anymore. Lift your hands to Jesus. Lift your hands to Jesus.
To all our dear ones in Canada, this is your opportunity to receive miracles, healings with signs, wonders, and life in abundance as Pastor Dill comes into Canada for miracle moments. Jesus loves you.
Many of us climb our own mountains. I want to be this, I want to be that, I want to do this. That's fine, my loving children. God is not against you. He has given you a free choice. He's your father. A father wants his child to express her heart or his heart. I want to be this, dad. I want to be this, dad. I want to do this. The father loves you. But he sweeps the child, whether young or old, in his arms, whether a father or mother, and tells, you can do all this when I take over. You can do all this. When I take over, you can do all this. That's what the Father says. That's what the Father says. That's what the Father, he is going to fulfill your desires. He is going to meet every need of your life. But he wants to take that position because when he's your Father, God Almighty, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Israel, when he takes the place that he's your Father through the blood of his Son, Jesus, my beloved ones, and you and I are his child, his children. You are not a slave anymore. You don't become a slave to money or wealth or achievements or career or this or that, that nothing takes your time away from his word, his spirit, his blood. You don't become a slave to the world. Galatians 4, verse number 6. You don't become a slave to some pleasure, some fulfillment, some satisfaction. This man became a slave and was almost gone, but God picked him up just because he called him my father one day and surrendered his life one day. God remembered that day. Oh, my loving Savior, he is here tonight. Be born again. Be born again. It's, my beloved, it's not a separate group. It is the only type of people who will be found in heaven forever. I can't help but say the truth. I can't help but to say what God says in the Bible. I can't help but preach the truth of the gospel. Woe unto me, as Paul the great apostle said, and this little apostle says, woe unto me if I don't preach the true gospel. He loves you. He wants to take the position as a father. I didn't say he's going to punish you. I never said that. I didn't say he's going to condemn you. I didn't say that. Bible doesn't say that. Luke 9:56, John 3:17, John 5:24. We all come with the Bible, the great Holy Spirit in me and in you. What we say is God wants to take the position as a father in your life. Yeah, I want to do this, Father. I want to do this, Father. I want to do that. I want to, yes, my son. Yes, my daughter. You can do it all, but let me take my position in your life now. He didn't say, oh, don't do that. Get away from my life. Don't give up all that and come. No, that's not the true gospel. He says, let me now take my place as your father. Come. This man came to Jesus. He was a total outcast, religious, social, cultural outcast. Even by the law, he was an outcast. He was virtually dying. He was virtually dying, fully afflicted with leprosy. My loving children, a contagious disease, I believe. And he didn't know where to go. He wanted to live. He wanted to live. If only this leprosy can be removed from my life, I can work, I can look after my family. He wanted to live. He didn't want to give up on life. He wanted to live. My loving child, tonight, The Holy Spirit is here today. Don't give up on anything that is going to bless your life in Jesus' name. He is here today. No matter how far the road is, no matter how hard the road is, my loving child, He will walk with you in every place. He will come with you in every place. When He takes the place of a father in your life, He is ready for a journey with you. He is ready for a walk with you, for a run with you. Sometimes He has to run because you run ahead. He has to come and catch you because you are running on your own. You don't know what the dirty, defeated devil has planned somewhere. You are running your life on your own, and the Father comes running after you. He comes running after you. When I say the Father, it's the Father's Spirit. My loving child, He comes running after you and catches you before you fall into a ditch or hurt yourself. He comes running after you. My son, I'm your father. Let me do it for you. You rest in me. Let me go ahead. I am your good shepherd. Psalm 23 verse 1. I will lead you. Let me go ahead. I am in you. Romans 8 verse number 14. You must be led by the Holy Spirit. Sometimes we run ahead. We run ahead in our workplace, in our career, in our personal life, in our finance, in our character, my loving children. And He has a time with us. He is coming after you, my loving children. I know that. He is coming after me. I know that. We run ahead of Him many times, but He is the Father. He comes after us. John 16 verse 32. My Father is with me, Jesus said. As how I am sent by my Father, I send you. He is told in John 20 verse 21. He is with us. Emmanuel, God with us to hold us. Because we have all fancy ideas. We all have all kinds of desires. So God holds us. My child, everything is going to be all right. You are going to be successful. You are going to be well. You are going to be healed. You are going to be blessed. You are going to have what you want. But let me take my position in your life. That's the message tonight. Let God be my Father forever. That's the theme tonight. Let God be my Father forever. Let God be my Father forever. This leper came there to Jesus. My beloved, he just came, and Bible says in Luke's Gospel chapter 5, 12, he fell at his feet. Matthew's Gospel 8th chapter verse 3 says he worshipped him. Luke 5, 12 says he fell at his feet. He was a leper dying, but he wanted to live. He wanted to live. He worshipped him. He worshipped Jesus. What did he say to Jesus when he worshipped him? At last, I found you. At last, I was nowhere in life. I was totally carried away by the things of the world. I couldn't see you, God. I couldn't see you as my Father. I couldn't see you as the one who was waiting for me to bless me with heaven on this earth. I was so surrounded with friends. I was so surrounded with colleagues. I was so surrounded with my work and my business and my meetings and my pleasure and my leisure. Lord, I was so caught up with what the doctors said that I'm not going to make it. My health is bad. It's deteriorating. I was worried. I was running here, there, everywhere. I thought I had to work hard. I was caught up. I was carried away. And I was consumed by the pleasures of the world. My loving children, you can be caught up. You can be carried away. You can be consumed, whether it's you or me or anyone, can be by the world, the things of the world, the pleasures. We think the world is going to satisfy us. Do you know what the world is like? John 15 verse 19. John 15 verse 19. The world hates you and me. Do you know that? My loving children, We think the world is our satisfaction. We think the world is our fulfillment. My loving, dearest children, but God says, my child, you are in the world, but I have taken you out of the world. John 17:6, John 17:8, John 17:11, John 17:12, John 17:14, 1 Peter 2:9, Colossians 1:13. How many references you want, we will give you. The great Holy Spirit through me, we will give you. My loving children, you and I are taken out of the world when you say, God, you are my Father, come and take your place tonight. That is the time. That is the time. Here is a man, came to Jesus, worshipped him. Worshipped him. He knew that he had found the one who will do it all for him. The world couldn't do it. Medicines couldn't do it. Doctors cannot do it. Money cannot do it. Friends cannot do it. Your own self efforts will not do it.
I am going to pray now. Shall we pray now? Loving Father, our gracious Father, our ever-loving Abba Father, in Jesus' name, I humble myself and come to you. The blood of your Son, Jesus, even today, cleanses us, saves us, and gives us the victory. Holy Spirit, we give it all to you. Come, Holy Spirit, take over. And in the name of Jesus, let everyone who watches these programs worldwide, Miracle Moments, let them receive God, life and life in abundance. Thank you, Father, in Jesus' name. Let them receive physical healing right now, Father, in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father. Let new organs be created in their bodies. Thank you, Father, in Jesus' name. Let there be lives with peace and joy in these long years until rapture, in Jesus' name. I thank you, Father. Let every home, every child, every man, woman who watches or hears these programs be so blessed, Father, with life in abundance, victorious in Jesus' name, until rapture, in midday with us, and eternal with you, Jesus, in our Father's mansions. Let every tear be wiped away. Let every tear be wiped away. Resurrected Jesus, my God and my Lord and our healer, let every tear be wiped away by the power of your Holy Spirit. Let them all rejoice. Let everyone rejoice in Jesus Christ forever. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Amen, amen, and amen.